we're now out of the city and here in the open roads with the Range Rover Evoque. Now, if you enjoy driving the Evoque in the city, you'll definitely enjoy driving this car out here on the open roads. This is where the car wants to be. Out here on the open roads on the twisties, you can tell how smooth the ride is. It's a pretty soft ride, and there's not a lot of body roll with this car, even when you're taking things at speed. At speed, you have 9 gears here going forward, and it's a 9-speed automatic, and with that, the car tries to change gears as early as possible so that it could get the best fuel economy possible. And so every once in a while, you might be surprised at how quick or how fast the rev range goes. It can go up to 4,000 RPMs at an instant. But of course, it's the car shifting gears as early as possible. Now, if you prefer to shift your own gears, you could always activate sport mode and put on the paddle shifters, just like what I did earlier. More things you'll like about this car, though, is that despite this car being a diesel, you won't hear a lot of the diesel sounds that this car would have. Every once in a while, maybe when you rev it up or when the car activates its start-stop function, the diesel noise will appear ever so slightly, but when it's at cruising speed, when you're cruising, it's absolutely fine. It's very quiet in that sense, and it's very refined in terms of its ride quality. Now, with its performance, you'll also like the idea that with the 9-speed automatic transmission, it can get quiet inside. But of course, you can still hear external noise, like those motorcycles passing me by earlier. And none of them were using their turn signals, by the way. But again, you know, of course, as you drive, drive safe and drive responsibly. Of course, with the Evoque, you'll like how they prioritize comfort here, and everything is accessible at a push of a button or even with your voice commands. The voice commands works the same way, just like the Defender before and just like the Velar, which we've tried before and previous episodes, and it's very intuitive and it's very, very easy to use. But going with that though, more things you like about this car is the confident feeling that you have with the Evoque. Match that with your all-terrain response system and or your auto-terrain response system, and you should be fine. So what would be a foreseeable concern you'll have with a Range Rover Evoque? It would be this. For a foreseeable concern, it would be getting familiar with your Evoque. Getting familiar with how you drive it, how you maintain it. Those are physical factors that you always have to consider, even with any car, but especially with this car, since, you know, admittedly, there's not a lot of Range Rovers on the road. But nevertheless, though, as long as you're in constant communication with your sales representative or your sales representative from Land Rover, rather, or even from the maintenance department or from the mechanics at the Land Rover, you should be okay. Just make sure you give them a call every once in a while if you have any questions, and they'll be more than glad to answer any of your questions about your car. And of course, going with that, you have to be familiar with how to maintain this car, when you change your oil and what have you. Those are physical concerns, and even using the car in terms of its tech and other features. But as long as you get familiar with it, spend a day or two with your Evoque, and you should be fine. After a full day with the Range Rover Evoque, what is the bottom line? Imagine going on a camping trip with your celebrity crush, and that's exactly what it feels like with this car. Okay, you will have physical concerns like what if she crashes, or what if she falls, or what if she doesn't like you back? That could happen, right? But then, on the upside, what if it does work out? What if she does like you back? What if it actually turns out great? And that could be the case here in this Evoque. Yes, there are physical concerns like you getting familiar with the car or the car getting familiar with you, but get over that, and anywhere you go should be a fun adventure, with or without that passenger princess.